are watching the 2011 Canada's Walk of Fame.
Hey, Howie.
Hey, Russell.
I
don't shake hands.
I know.
I hug. I'll hug. I just don't shake hands.
I can probably hug.
Okay.
Do I hug back or do I just accept the hug?
Whatever. I'll hug. There you go. Okay. Nice. All right. Okay. Ooh.
Oh, that's. Don't worry about that. That's just a pigeon.
Nice. Well.
Enjoying the show.
What do you got coming up next?
I'm just, they're doing a package for Drake.
Oh, I like Drake. He's a friend of mine.
Do you want to do it?
Yeah, I'll do it.
Okay, go ahead.
I guess we'll do it like this, huh? This next guy, he's gone from wheelchairs to Maybachs. And he is the voice of hip-hop right now. Not just in Canada, worldwide. Let's check this pack out. Hey, what do you mean by pack?
My pigeon's coming out. My pigeon's coming out.
That's not a pigeon.
I don't know if you've ever seen a woman listen to a Drake song, but there's a certain oh my godness that they say to it. Like they'll hear it and they'll go, oh my god, that's Drake.
You know, a lot of girls be thinking my songs are about them. This is not to get confused. This one's for you. Baby, you my
the meteoric rise of Toronto hip-hop artist Drake is nothing short of stunning.
It's just crazy how fast everything has happened, because it seems like last week that I was in my mom's basement saying I want to do hip-hop music. And now, you know, I go places and people say you're the most anticipated artist coming out of Canada in years.
He's like a modern-day poet.
His unique reflective songwriting combines fierce rap with soulful sensitivity.
He's got his own sound. When you look at what he does lyrically and for the singing on top of that, fused with that, it's a whole different level.
Drake, under his real name, Aubrey Graham, first achieved success as an actor portraying the character of Jimmy Brooks on the hit TV show Degrassi, The Next Generation.
Look, save the bully crap for someone who won't fight back.
Drake recorded and released a series of mixtapes. The song Replacement Girl emerged as an underground hit and came to the attention of superstar rapper Lil Wayne.
Wayne had heard a couple songs, and about two or three songs in, he called my cell phone. I was getting a haircut, and he just asked me to come down to Houston the next day, and from there, you know, we just formed this bond, this friendship.
It may not mean nothing to y'all, but understand nothing was done for me. So I don't plan on stopping at all. I won't forever mind, ever mind, ever mind.
A recording deal was signed. Music collaborations were recorded. And suddenly the music community was talking about the new hip hop artist out of Canada.
Drop the mixtape, they said it sounded like an album. Yeah. Who'd have thought a countrywide tour would be the outcome? Yeah. Labels want my name beside an X like Malcolm.
He's the artist of the time right now. You gotta think about him. Drake got 2 Grammy nominations before the album even dropped. That's unprecedented in music altogether.
This is what I'ma do till it's over, till it's over. That's as far from over.
And the Juno goes to Drake!
Back in Canada, he picked up 2 Juno Awards and performed with Justin Bieber.
First of all, I want to dedicate this award to my mother. You know, she's responsible for not only the artist I am, but the man that I am.
And my father is just where I get it all from. My father wrote for Al Green and drummed for Jerry Lee Lewis.
When Drake's debut album, Thank Me Later, finally dropped, it debuted at #1 on the Billboard album charts and sold over 400,000 copies in its first week of release. And a performance in New York was canceled by the police, causing chaos when too many fans turned up. Drake has collaborated with the who's who of hip-hop and R&B. Jay-Z, Eminem, Kanye West, Rihanna, the list goes on. He has even organized and sponsored his own music festival, OVO. And this past spring, his full range of skills were on display when he hosted the annual Juno Awards.
Good evening. I would like to welcome everybody here with us to my hometown and the greatest city in the entire world, Toronto!
The expectations are high for Drake. His sophomore album, Take Care, is due to be released October 24th. That coincides with his 25th birthday.
My sound is just going to be something that just causes you to think. I want you to think when you listen to my music. I want you to appreciate it. I want it to be timeless.
Congratulations, Drake, for winning the Alan Slaight Award. Make Toronto and Canada so proud.
Apparently he knows way too many people in this place right now that he didn't know last year. I think I'm included in that group. Congratulations, Aubrey.
God bless you, man. Continue knocking it out the park. Represent Canada.
Drake, congratulations on your Alan Slaight Award. You deserve it, man.
Last name ever, first name greatest.
That's your boy. Yeah.
Alan Slaight is a leading figure in Canadian broadcasting and a dedicated philanthropist. Now in its second year, the Alan Slaight Award is presented annually to a young Canadian making a positive impact. And no one is more deserving of this award than Drake. Now, Drake, before you get your award, we've got one more surprise for you, okay? We put together an awesome performance that I think you're really gonna like. We need a minute. You probably need a minute. Stay right where you are, and we will be back with a surprise for Drake.
You are watching the 2011 Canada's Walk of Fame.